Hello Transformer fans, this is Brad92, and today I'll be looking at the Combiner Wars Off-Road, which is the replacement for Wild Rider, which is now coming out, and I believe it's a repaint, possibly, probably a retool of Dead End. But he is definitely different looking compared to Wild Rider, who was a sports car. Here's the Fans Project version. You can see the colors are similar, but the design is different. Although he looks a lot more like the knockoff oversized Wild Rider. Even though one's a truck, one's a Hummer, but still. If he was like this color, which I really should repaint him, he'd be cool in this color. Oh well. I just thought it was neat. Now, I do like how he looks. He has this cool little design on the side. He has a nice paint on the front. Nothing on the back. And you can take his weapons, which this is weird. I think it's a... that's the wrong one. I am a liar. Is this one. I think this is supposed to be a another engine block. But it's kind of... it's different looking. Once again, you put it in the back. And I think it's just a little... Oh, it works! Holy crap, it does work. So I can have like an engine... Well, it just barely works. It scrapes against the ground. It still is kind of weird. Oh well, it's at least it works, sort of. And I can take it. Now, I'd like to be able to put it on here. And you can, but that's not really cool. So you can stick on the side where, like, the gas tank would go. And he has an awesome melee weapon. Look at that. Like a Zaku 2 Hinok. I like it. And then pick it there. Yeah, it looks kind of weird, but it is storage for the weapons if you want to. Now his transformation, the legs are exactly like the aerial bots, which could be good, could be bad. It works. It works a lot better than Dead End's because they actually peg together and stay pegged together. Once you get them pegged together, there we go. So it's good. Now, this part here, that's what you gotta do. I'm not really happy with that. Just a big, lumpy piece on the back. And I really, really, really want to keep these door panels up like this. And then do that. But the problem is that if you have the hood the way it's supposed to be, it starts to get in the way. So you're supposed to keep it down. Even that limits it. But it gives you a little more range than having it straight up. But I just think it'd be cool to give him big shoulder pads. And does that look cool? I think that looks kind of cool. With his colors especially. But no, keep him down. Keep that down. And there he is. There is Off-Road in his Rebel Mode back. Not happy with it. Panels, not happy with it. Really like the head. The head's very different. And the color scheme on the limbs and the head scream G2. Well, the rest of it screams, like, G1. Which is a little... it's different. And they really painted the head. A little Decepticon logo there. Nice little silver on the hydraulic detailing. Not too bad, all in all. I got a ball-jointed head and shoulder, which hinders by the stupid thing here. He has a ratcheted elbow and a swivel at the elbow. And then he has a swivel waist, ball joint hip, swivel, and a bend at the knee. So it's not too bad. Not too bad. And the fact that his legs can actually do the stuff without unpegging is good. And of course you can take his weaponry, give him his hand-foot gun, and his awesome axe. And there he is. And that is Off-Road. He is the black sheep of the Stunticon team, because obviously he did not exist before. But I like him. Once again, just like with, what's his name? Alpha Bravo. He's different. He's not a sports car. He's not something like the other ones are pretty much the same. He is a truck. And I think it's nice. So, yeah, that's just me. But if you like this guy, click the link below to go to Big Bad Toy Store, and I'll see you in the next review.